What's going on, guys? Today, I'll be showing you how we make the Bleach Yes I Shoot model shirt. Today, we're going to be working on a Bleach, a model shirt that's going to be purple with like a neon pink kind of a look. You see me putting on gloves here, and then you kind of see them disappear. It's because I took the gloves off, because it is harder to work with gloves, but it is recommended that you work with gloves. So what I do is use a stencil to lay out the words that I want on my shirt. So right here, you see me putting a white stencil on. It doesn't matter what color the stencil is. It's actually a sticker type stencil. So that way it can stick and be peeled back off. And then you can actually use these multiple times. Using a gilded shirt in this one, it's not usually the shirt that we usually use, but these are more experimental type shirts. So today we're using gilded, and gilded's actually bleached really well. So that's what we're using today. So right, you see me putting in the the word model on the shirt. It looks a little crooked, but I'm gonna go back and fix it once I get all these stickers off of this thing. So you can go ahead and like kind of position it, and then go back and then reposition so it looks good. And I like to eyeball just to give it that more of an artistic feel that like somebody did this, that we made this. Like, so all the Bleach shirts are custom handmade, so like they're not made run through a machine or anything like that. They're actually just made with your hands. And then so here I'm putting on the YSM symbol on the bottom, but this is not the traditional YSM symbol. This is just like a YISM. I'm using a wooden stencil to put it on the bottom of the word. If you've seen the hustle shirt that we did, it's also on there. So just make sure the stickers are flat, and then you want to spray over the top, like a straight down angle on the words themselves. That way you make sure you get all the, because the angles, because if with the wood, the angle kind of makes a weird thing if you don't spray it straight down. So you need to spray it straight down. So you can give it a light mist. The more misty it is, the sharper the letters actually come out. So on the words, you want to do a mist. And the bleach that I'm using is actually straight bleach, because I want to make sure this shirt actually bleaches. But to get different effects, you can mix bleach with water, and it'll actually give you like better effects, different effects. So depending on how you want it to look. And like you can crunch it up like I'm doing right now, and it gives give you different different designs within the bleach. And like you like can get fancy with it, do whatever you want. You can rubber band it like almost like you were doing tie-dye. And then I use that paper towel to actually just get some of the bleach off of the letters when I peel them up like I'm doing right now. That doesn't just like drip all over the place. So you'll see the bleach is slowly changing the color of the shirt. And like where I'm peeling the letters off from, the bleach didn't touch at all. And it keeps it away from like dripping in. And that light mist, it prevents it from like seeping underneath the actual letters. And after a while, those letters will like start getting messed up, and then it will start like leaking in. But it worked. I'll say you can do about a good 10 shirts on those single letters. And then you can just get fancy with the actual bleaching. So just kind of bleach wherever you want, drip some bleach here and there. You know, put your own taste into it, put your own touch into it. That's why each one of these Bleach shirts is kind of an art piece, because I hand make these myself. And like, I just go to town, whatever looks good to me, I just kind of do it. And I love it. Another thing, when you're doing this, make sure you wear safety glasses, because the bleach does spray up a splatter and you get it in your eye, it's gonna have a bad day. So see how I folded it? Like when you do that fold like there, it'll give it like a line. It'll do kind of like a lot of different weird things. So depending on how you fold it, you can even crinkle it up if you wanted to, and just get it all over there. Like I like to hit the edges. So I'm doing it faster here. Here's a faster view of it, so you can kind of see this is a totally different shirt. So yeah, adjusted it, put the words on the bottom, I'm spraying over top, and then lightly dampen it off, pull those, I'm just going ham all around it, just like spray. So you see how I'm dripping and the water's draining down? So this is kind of how you get the lightning strike kind of feel into the bleach. So it's gonna do like a little zigzag going down the shirt, like a drip. So those look pretty cool in the color change. Kind of looks like lightning. And here's some finished products. You see the there's a little bit of bleach inside some of the words, but that's cool. It just gives it its own feel. Each shirt is different. No shirt is going to be the same. And that's a quick overview of how we make our bleachers at Yes I Shoot Bombs. Thank you.